weeks, Andrew Tate is even more popular than Mr. Beast by Google searches right now. This will change because that's how trends work, but he's hot. He's hot. And you might be wondering, who the hell is Andrew Tate? Good question. He's a former kickboxing world champion turned reality star when he joined Big Brother. But then he got kicked off Big Brother because it was discovered that he was beating women. But then the woman he was beating said it was consensual and BDSM. So I don't know, make of that what you will. And then he was also famous because he was running a online fan cam service. Basically, he was a pimp for women online and they were selling relationships to men and farming them for all the money they have. It actually made him millions and millions of dollars, but he quit. Not because he like felt bad and was the whole I'm not your friend thing. It's because the Romanian police raided his house and there was claims that people were there against his will. And I don't think anybody wants that heat. But why are we talking about him now? Why is he hot right now? Why is he so controversial that a man named Andrew Tate had to change his name on Twitch because he was getting so much hate? Well, the reason is his new venture, Hustlers University, basically selling a lifestyle to mostly teenaged boys. He is a powerful, strong, rich man, and he's trying to tell you, the average man, that you can have this lifestyle if you just follow his class. Here's a real clip, by the way, of him advertising it.
I get called Morpheus a lot. I get called Morpheus all the time in my DMs because I'm trying to wake people
up. All the time.
If the Matrix is real and you're watching this video, I am Morpheus.
I get called really tall and funny all the time. I'm not making this up. This is super real. Now, Andrew Tate, if that was all he was known for, wouldn't be someone we would be talking about today. But he's also a man who has very, very controversial takes. And smartly, he doesn't always spout these takes on his own streams. He goes on media tours of random podcasts and says them there. Takes like this.
I was getting on a plane and I could see through the cockpit that a female was the pilot. And I took a picture and I said, most women I know can't even park a car. Why is a woman flying my plane?
Crazy stuff. Crazy stuff. He's also said that women can't drive because he's been in 5 car accidents and every single accident was with a woman driver. And also him driving, but I don't think he's noticed that consistent variable. He has other gross things like this.
Person who feels like they need therapy, you're useless. Because in the harshest realities of this cold world, there are people in Syria whose entire families have been blown to fuck, who are still getting up every day, making fucking bread and selling it on the streets so they have enough money to buy a new pair of sandals sometime next year.
Forget about the Jordan Peterson make your bed. We've moved on. It's time to make bread, fellas. If you're not making bread, you're a beta bitch. All right, and that's just the fact. And it all kind of came to a head, him having this career of Hustlers University and trying to sell this lifestyle. And then the Twitch sphere when he hopped on Aiden Ross's stream. And this was a huge, huge stream. And from my perspective as a guy who's pretty confident in his morals and his ethics and what guides me as a human, it was pretty fucking funny. I mean, here's a clip from it.
My neighbor, she's only about 15, 16 year old girl, lives a couple of houses away.
Yeah.
I hope she ain't watching because she was looking for a cat the other day and my pit bull ate it. So,
Oh, God.
And
oh
I put a
God.
Sign up, cats don't come inside. But cats are such arrogant little fuckers, they must have read the sign and thought, fuck this guy. They're either too stupid to read or they're arrogant and ignored me.
For sure.
I thought cats were fast, but it turns out pit bulls are faster. My cat.
Okay, so That's the GTA NPC that is Andrew Tate. And that stream was big. And there was kind of a problem with it. Aiden Ross said yes to every single thing Andrew Tate was spitting out, even the sexist shit. And the problem with Andrew Tate is he doesn't only say dumb shit, crazy shit, funny stories. He also ties in some pretty basic life lessons, like this one.
Have you ever seen anyone with a vape? Have you ever sat in a room? So we go, wait, oh, let me just, my vape's done charging. Load it up. I mean, I smoke cigars, but I know what the fuck I'm doing. Give me a big fat cigar. I'm risking cancer to look like a mafia boss. Fine. I'm not sitting there smoking cigars and going, I can't believe this is bad for me. No, like these fucking vape bullshit children.
Mm.
And what kind of parent lets their 16-year-old vape anyway?
Fair.
If I had a 16-year-old son, he's like, I got a vape. Get the fuck out of here, vape. Do some push-ups. You ain't got time to vape. You gotta do push-ups. You ain't got time.
And so he has these like pretty basic tidbits of truth bombs, of knowledge. And then he ties it in with charismatically told funny stories. And then he drops a few little sexist remarks in there. And all of that led to his chat, Aiden Ross, that is, W-ing everything that Andrew Tate would say, and Aiden Ross going along with everything as well. And it led to 266,000 people watching at once. So I kind of get why Aiden Ross didn't really push back. He was probably too busy staring at the viewership number. I mean, he went so far to yes and everything Tate was saying that they had this insane moment.
Let me ask you a question first.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen the clown that hides from gay people?
No.
Of course you haven't.
Stupid, stupid shit. But it's a problem too, because he takes advantage of the people who are watching. These people who look up to Tate because he's strong and he gets women and he has a lot of money. They're going down, I think, a bad path. A path where they're listening to one man to pull all their ideals from. I mean, look at this clip. This is, I think, one of the best examples of Tate farming that string and trying to get people who are lonely to go take his class.
I think most women can actually genuinely understand how lonely the majority of men are. And you need to truly understand, if you're Joe Schmo, average in nearly every way, in Starbucks working, you ain't getting a DM ever. You girls will never be lonely. As much as you might be unhappy with the possible suitors, you can at least fuck about and flirt if you feel sad. There are men out here in the world who have genuine loneliness.
This video has 10 million views. Now, obviously, women can also be lonely. All right, the guy who's working at Starbucks who gets no DMs, maybe if you're looking at the hot girl in class who's going out, you'll be like, oh, women are going out. There's a girl in your class who's probably feeling the same way you do. It might disproportionately affect men. I don't know. I'm not a man of the studies. But all I do know is that his solution for this is, I am rich, I get bitches, I have Bugatti, give me $50 every single month, and I'll tell you how to be exactly like me. That's what they do. $50 a month. Now, a couple of months ago, there were 50,000 people who were signed up for his course. That's $2.5 million every single month. It's like 25 mil a year. Imagine now, after the blow up, it might be 2, 3, 5 times that amount. He's not going to stop. Why would he? He's only getting praise from a lot of teenage kids online. The only real pushback I've ever seen of Tate was from this one podcast he did with Portnoy on the BFFs pod.
You say a lot of stuff about women like that they're your property.
That's not what I said. I was talking about an OnlyFans company when that question was asked. But I said that if a woman is going out with a man, she belongs to that man. That's his woman. So if she wants to do OnlyFans, she owes him some money because she's his.
Well, that's crazy. It's crazy.
That one's crazy.
Do you think that a man going out with a girl, that's just your property?
That one was nuts.
I'm nuts now. Good.
If a guy and a girl is dating and a girl does OnlyFans, she owes him a cut?
She is his girl.
But what does that have to do with anything?
Because she's his.
So that is you saying that women are your property.
It's not about being property. It's about the fact that she belongs to him. And the intimate parts of her body belong to him because they're in a relationship. And if she wants to sell those, he has a stake in those intimate parts of her body.
So it's reverse. A male porn star owes the woman.
I don't know, because I think the women belong to the man. I think the woman.
Yeah, that's inherently where you get called sexist for.
No, it's not property. It's just she belongs to me and she's mine. It's not property. No one else can have her and she's mine. Now, the problem is that this Tate character that he puts on it. And I don't think it is a character in the sense that he doesn't believe these things. I think it's a character in the sense that he uses his charisma and he makes up stories and he tries to sell it in a way that is more palatable. It gets a lot of weird, weird followers. Now, you've probably seen Tate clips online. When you see them, do me a favor. Check to see if there's a description that has a referral link to his course. It's kind of like a little baby pyramid scheme. Because they have referral links like early days in Uber, and all these alpha males try to make a little bit of bread by getting their other lonely friends to hop on the trend so they can all get rich. And it creates weird ass copies like this guy.
You want to learn about Hustlers University, eh? You're a young male or an Apache attack helicopter.
Tango down.
Or a female. God help us all.
Who are like devoid of all of the charisma and only have the shitty qualities. Not to say Tate's a good person, but that guy's a goddamn robot. The only thing he shares with Tate is his bald ass head. And I'm kind of scared of this. Honestly, I can watch Tate and I can laugh about it and then move on because it's not going to impact how I feel about things. I've kind of formed my identity over 27 years, and it's still changing. I still like to challenge my ideas by looking at new things, talking to new people, reading new books, whatever it is. But there are people, and I think this is so beta, who give this man $50 and then subscribe to every single thing he says. It blows my mind. I don't get it. Growing up, I wanted someone who could guide me. My dad died when I was 10, and I found that in Woody's gamer tag. He did a series called Mail Monday, and I think I was really lucky, because if I had watched someone else like 12 years ago and I'm 15 years old, I could have gotten down a weird path. I could be a weird fucking guy who probably would have joined a frat and only cared about fucking bitches and hedonistic goals trying to make my life right now happier. And not like better things that give you more fulfillment in the totality of your life. This guy was an absolute legend. He's the guy who inspired what my channel is today. I mean, originally, Mogul Mail, Mail Monday, it was supposed to be letters from you guys and I would give advice to it. I found out pretty quickly that all of you guys just want to figure out how to deal with breakups, and I feel like I've talked about that. Or you have problems that I don't feel like I have the expertise to talk about. So instead, what I like to do is just turn on the camera for 15 minutes, talk about something I'm interested in, and inject how I feel about it. But the one thing that I'm down to do that I wish someone like Tay would be down to do is be challenged. I'm not here to tell you I'm the alpha. I know everything. Listen to me. I'm here to tell you how I feel about a thing. And I've been wrong in the past. Way wrong. Not just talking about like Batman, bad takes. I've had dumb things that I've said. Coinbase sponsorship, just to start. But I'm okay with being challenged. I always say at the end of the video, let me know how you feel. Let me know if you disagree. And I do read the comments that are kind of filled with bots these days. Kind of need to fix that. And I'm worried. Just worried about a future generation. So if you have a friend who's tape-pilled, talk to him. Let him know. Maybe you think it's whack. You can tell him it's whack. Maybe you don't think it's whack, but ask him why they feel that way. And at least engage in discourse. Maybe there's some positive you can do from that. Anyway, that's all, boys. That's the Andrew Tate thing. Didn't think I was going to talk about it, but it's blown up so much and it doesn't seem like it's cooling down. I had to. Let me know if you disagree. If you're tape-pilled, why? And see you later. See you in the next one. Don't know what it'll be, but sometime soon. Subscribe if you want. I don't care. Bye.
All right, let me know when you're ready. That one's hard, dude.
So which one was this? 5.5?
Oh, yes, my. Yeah.
It's 11 modules!
11 mods, yeah.
Why are there...
it to the shower by a quarter to one. This bottle shampoos and conditions.
Hey, so I've been stuck inside like all of you for the last couple of weeks. I'm going a little crazy, so I thought I'd do a little song like I used to in one of these videos. Hope you like it. Here it is.
Trying to be funny and stuck in a room. There isn't much else to say about it. Can one be funny when stuck in a room? Being in trying to get something out of it. Try making faces. Try telling jokes, making little sounds.
I'm gonna make microwave popcorn.
So I've been filming things for like a month now, and I don't really have anything that's even kind of close to usable yet. So I'm just hoping I can write or film something soon that's usable, or I'm gonna just stop and play PlayStation. Is this fucking doing anything? Is this looking cool? Is this fucking stupid? Is this fucking stupid or fucking... Stupid little bitch. That left is off. Left is off. There's something to do about it. Being the center of attention. Healing the world with comedy.
Because jeans don't watch the news. jeans don't read Twitter. Jeans are just jeans. So if you're tired of the bullshit, the politics, the constant arguing, buy some jeans and find out why jeans are jeans.
I want to know when Dippin' Dots is going to condemn child sex trafficking.
That's how it works. You know what, boys and girls? I think we need to say hi to our friend Socko. Hey, Socko. Where have you been, Socko?
Favorite word is moist, and you tell people that, I hate you. And I'm every person that says that they hate the word moist, they think they're the first person who have said, they think they're that's a novel idea. Everyone hates moist. It's unoriginal and it's stupid, and stop saying that like it's interesting. My least favorite word, by the way, is injustice.
Hey, baby. It's me. Our anniversary's coming up. It's a pretty big one. And I wrote a song for you. So I'm just leaving you this voicemail because I want the song to begin with this voicemail. Like, I want the voicemail to play in the beginning of it. So if you could just download this voicemail when you get it and then text it to me. You might need to, like, download another app to download I don't know if you can rip your voicemail right off your phone. You might need to, like, just Google it. Don't call me and ask me, because I know what you're going to do. You're gonna get this, and you're going to think you just can't do it, and you're going to call me. But then I'm just going to Google it. So just you Google it. You're an adult. You can figure it out. So just figure it out and text me the voicemail immediately, if you wouldn't mind. Like, right when you get this. Thank you. I love you. Bye.
You're my best friend. I love you.
Love you. Love you.
You know me, and I know you.
Know you.
We got problems that we've been through.
Been through.
We got shit that we'll get through. You think I'm rude to you. You think I am the worst. Because I ask when you suck my dick. You take out your Invisalign first. Come on. 5 years, 5 years. Still you, still me, still here. 5 years, 5 years, baby. 5 years, 5 years. We order Chinese, I'm eating my dumplings. You reach over and you take my dumpling. You don't even say, do you mind or nothing? Why would you assume that you're entitled to a dumpling? So I look at you, you look back at me like, what the fuck did I do? If you really wanted some dim sum then, you really should have gotten some. When we put in the order, you say you're a psycho, and I don't wanna fight, so let's just drop this, it's not a big deal. Okay, but for the record, you owe me a dumpling. I mean it, I won't forget. You owe me a dumpling or a dumpling equivalent. 5 years, 5 years, still you, still me, still here. 5 years, 5 years, baby. 5 years, 5 years. in the house. You freaked and you jumped up onto the couch. Since I was close and able, I jumped up on the coffee table. You said you should kill that. I said I'm no fuck that. You said come on, be a man. What? You're a total anti-sexist, a patriarchy fighter, but your whole worldview collapses the moment there's a spider. Cool, I get it, this is the real you. It's a pleasure, nice to meet you. Shit like this brings the movement down. Everyone's a feminist until there is a spider around. 5 years, 5 years, still you, still me, still here. 5 years. How come every time I need to take a poo in the bathroom, you out of the blue need to use the bathroom? Just use the guest room bathroom. That's why we got two bathrooms. Just use the guest room bathroom. That's why we got two bathrooms. And you know.
I used to perform comedy on a stage in front of people, living humans. And I would try to be funny, and then the audience would sometimes laugh. And that was really helpful because I would hear their laughter, and that would let me know that what I was doing was funny to them. As opposed to now, where I'll try to be funny, like, and then you see what I'm saying? What is up? Welcome back to another episode of the podcast. I am your host, Bo Burnham, joined in studio, as always, by my co-host, Bo Burnham.
What up, what up, what up?
And we are two comedians who are talking shit, no filter, not giving a fuck what anybody thinks.
Not a fuck.
And, yeah, not apologizing for it.
Apologizing,
let's get into it. We might say some crazy shit.
Yeah, let's do it.
PC culture, man. It's
fucking exhausting,
right,
bro.
It's fucking out of control.
Exhausting.
It's just... our culture has been taken over by
taken
a radical
over.
Group of SJW feminist freaks.
Feminist, yeah.
Who hate comedians.
They hate us.
Who are anti-comedy and anti-joke.
Totally.
And it's gotten to the point where you can't say anything.
No,
literally.
100%.
You cannot say anything.
Literally.
I mean, I will try to say something right now.
Yeah.
Watch.
Mm.
Yeah, and he is trying.
And it's unbelievable because we have fallen so far from the heyday of comedy.
So depressing, dude.
When, you know, Tony the Pancake was headlining the Comedy Store.
Or Salami Williams.
On a Tuesday night.
Oh,
they would crush.
They'd just fucking murder.
Just destroying.
Just fucking
absolute.
Just crush.
crushing, dude. You know, and it sucks because these people, they don't understand comedy.
Of course not.
We're joking.
It's not that serious, guys. It's not that joking around.
And also, as comedians are philosophers.
Yes,
all right, Lenny Bruce, Richard Pryor.
We hold up a mirror,
history-changing cultural figures, and you need to recognize that. All right, comedy is an art form.
Yeah, of course it is. We're artists.
It's an art form, and it's important because it's one of the only art forms that is not gay.
No,
we can't say that. But gay. But yeah, not. Now they're gonna come after us, right? We're gonna get canceled for saying this.
You homophobes.
We're not being homophobic. Okay,
no, it's
when we say that.
Gay is just.
If there was another word that meant gay that wasn't gay, we'd use that.
We would.
But there isn't one.
But there isn't. So it's gay.
But yeah, so it's really just a war on comedy that I realized. I was having a conversation with my sparring partner.
Nice.
And I realized that the war on comedy is really.
Come on, Jeffrey, you can do it. Pay the way. Put your back into it. Tell us why. Show us how. Look at where you came from. Look at you now. Zuckerberg and Gates and Buffett. Amateurs can fucking suck it. Fuck their wives. Drink their blood. Come on, Jeff. Get him! Reflector, different colored back wall. That's good for something. That's good. Now we're fucking talking. Ooh. Yeah. Oh my. Oh. I get a lot of questions from young people. They'll say, how can I create content that will cut through the noise? And I tell them, be yourself, okay? Because the landscape is so competitive. There are so many people with so many different skills. The only thing you really have to offer at the end of the day is yourself. So offer yourself by being yourself. And if that doesn't work, then be somebody else, because you may suck. Who you are on a fundamental, sort of unchangeable level may just be uninteresting and unwatchable and useless. So if you're that, be somebody else for sure. And then if that doesn't work, then go like this.
They're really gonna make me vote for Joe Biden. The best case scenario, Joe Biden. They're really gonna make me vote for Joe Biden. How is the best case scenario, Joe?
When I was 16 years old, I started posting videos on YouTube. This was 2006, and YouTube was very new at the time. And I posted videos of me performing songs that I thought were funny, that I had written. And I performed these songs in my childhood bedroom, which was my bedroom at the time, because I was a child. And in hindsight, it just seems absolutely insane and invasive and strange. But it didn't feel like that at the time. It felt exciting. And soon after I posted...
Hi, gang.
My first couple of videos, they went viral. Basically, within a year of that, I started to perform comedy professionally. And I continued doing that until the age of 25, when I stopped. But yeah, so since I started so young, basically every shitty joke, every sort of misstep is there's a lot of material that I'm just really embarrassed by and makes me cringe for a lot of reasons. And just edgy, stupid. Yeah, it doesn't hold up, and I don't know, I often wish that I could just, you know, start over and without all the, but I also know that if I didn't have that early material, I wouldn't be where I am today or where I was before I locked myself in this room and lost my mind.
It's overwhelmingly white. Fuck you, dude. Fuck you. All right? Look at me. Fuck you. Fuck you.
Ooh. Give it to me. Fuck. Damn it. Outside again.
Got used to meeting people who weren't used to meeting someone who was born in 1990, no way. Now I'm turning 30. Oh, I used to be the young one. Got used to meeting women.
So it's been many, many months now of working on this fucking thing every single day, which is, you know, a little longer than I thought it was going to be when I started. But, you know, most days I feel pretty good. You know, it feels like I'm staying busy and it's been fun. And then other days, like today, I just feel like I'm completely spinning my wheels and wasting my time, and I've now committed myself to never finishing this thing and just being in this room until I fucking... But if you're watching this, that means I did finish, so that's really, really good. Or it means that they found my body and that this footage was just sort of with my body.
How's it going? 1, 2, yeah. How you feeling? Say, what's up, you useless fuck? Are you feeling what I'm feeling? I haven't had a shower in the last 9 days. Staring at the ceiling and waiting for this feeling to go away. But it won't go away. I'm not really feeling like I want to get lit. Well, I feel like shit. Feeling like a saggy, massive sack of shit. Big ol' motherfucking duffel bag of shit. I'm all day, all that shit. I'm really feeling like I wanna get lit. I'm feeling like shit. Ladies, do you feel like shit? Tell me, do you feel like shit? Fellas, are you feeling like shit? Tell me, are you feeling like shit? Ladies, do you feel like shit? Tell me, do you feel like shit? Fellas, are you feeling like shit? Tell me, are you feeling like shit?
Fuck me, man. Jesus.
What's up, insider?
Community College. I am your dean with a few corrections to the fall class catalog. Cosmology should be cosmetology. Astrology should be astronomy. And the students on the cover should be smiling, but I suppose that's a matter of opinion. Whoever is growing a small patch of cannabis behind the gymnasium, congratulations. You have won a cruise. Report to security to claim your tickets. In order to increase awareness of homelessness, security has been given binoculars. In campus news, the debate over our library's PA system continues, with some students suggesting its volume be lowered, while others question its very purpose. More on that story as it unfolds.
That dude makes a lot of announcements.
I like it. It makes every 10 minutes feel like the beginning of a new scene of a TV show. Of course, the illusion only lasts until someone says something they never say on TV, like how much their life is like TV. There, it's gone.
I guess Jeff's running late again.
Oh, what a shame. Maybe we should get started on you.
Oh, no. I think we should wait for Jeff before we start studying.
But maybe when Jeff gets here, we could talk to him as a group about his tardiness.
Oh, come on now. Don't use that word around, eh, Ben? In any case, if you want me to have a chat with Jeff, I'd be happy to do it. We've got a bond going, kind of. Sort of like brothers.
I hope your mom didn't make you take baths together, because one of you would have been like 30.
That's funny.
You know, Jeff probably comes late, so he doesn't have to sit through all of your tardiness. Sorry, Abed.
Okay, well, you guys have some self-respect. You are obsessing over someone who does not give you a second thought. Meanwhile, in Guatemala, journalists are being killed by their own government.
Maybe you jumped a column there. What's happening in Guatemala?
Nothing. Journalists are being murdered? Believe me, every day in that country, people are being killed for speaking out. And the worst part of it is, when it's all over...
Spoilers.
It's gonna be as if it never even happened. Hey, Abed? Real stories? They don't have spoilers. You understand that TV and life are different, right?
Hey!
My lady.
My lord.
Hey, baby.
Hi, sweetie.
You smell nice. Vitamin P.
Morning, Jeffrey. People were jazzed to see me, too.
Word of mouth!
Everywhere.
Good entrance.
Just for you.
Thank you.
Britta?
Hey, Jeff. I think there's something that the group would like to talk to you about.
Actually, there's nothing more to say.
I was just awesome.
Okay, if you're gonna study with people, it would be cool of you to show up on time.
Oh, were you waiting?
No.
I just got here.
No. Because you guys usually spend the first 20 minutes talking about your interesting personal lives and your cool emotional problems, and I just feel like I never have anything to offer.
Aww.
No, truth is, my life is emptier than this three-ring binder.
Oh,
Annie, do you have any Spanish notes that might fit in there? Wow, double spaced. Thank you.
So what's a guy got to do to get a C around here?
Give me some more time in a dream.
You know what today is? It's the 2-week anniversary of my horrible first impression.
There's a card for that?
Well, not specifically, but if you think of grandsons as metaphors for friendship, I think you'll agree with this transformer here that it's time for ours to become a man by reading from the Torah.
Look, Jeff, you're harmless enough to me because a life full of ups and downs has given me douche-ray vision, but those are good people in there. And they trust and respect you, and watching you exploit them kind of bums me out.
Exploit them? They're my friends.
Can I bring your car around, Jeff?
No, Abed. I don't want you to bring my car around. I'll bring yours around. Good guy, you get going, all right.
You're cute, but selfish and narcissistic to the point of near delusion.
She said I was cute.
Tell you what, you take her. I have less to prove. You know, Jeff, you can't pursue people so desperately. It starts to creep them out. Why don't we go get a beer? I'll give you some advice, and we can have what the kids are calling a sausage fest.
I'm not much of a sausage guy, Pierce. Maybe next time.
Next time, then. Hey.
Britta, will you tell us more about Guatemala?
I never went to a real college. I want to be political.
Well, that's good. You guys should discover that stuff on your own.
Yeah, but we need your help. We've been living on the wrong side of the looking glass. You're like
Jodie Foster or Susan Sarandon. You'd rather keep it real than be likable.
Can you at least tell us what to Google?
You could start with this journalist, Chikata Panikos. He wrote an article critical of the government, and they killed him.
Oh, that's horrible. Can we have a protest?
I want to protest the hell out of something.
I can have a candlelight vigil like lesbians have on the news.
I can make brownies. Brownies?
Every once in a while, a student will come up to me and ask, Senor Chang, why do you teach Spanish? They say it just like that.
Why do you teach Spanish? Why you?
Why not Matt? Why not photography? Why not martial arts? I mean, surely it must be in my nature to instruct you in something that's ancient and secret, like, oh, building a wall that you can see from outer space. Well, I'll tell you why I teach Spanish. It is none of your business, okay? And I don't want to have any conversations about what a mysterious, inscrutable man I am. I am a Spanish genius. In Espanol, my nickname is El Tigre Chino. Because my knowledge will bite her face off. So don't question Senor Chang, or you'll get bit. You bit. Okay. Friday mañana, we'll be having conversations with the rest of the class using some of the phrases we learned in Unit 1. You'll be partnering up in pairs of dos. So if you look under your desk, you'll find a card with either a picture or a word on it. Okay? For ejemplo, Blondie aquí has a card with a picture of a house on it. So that means a person with a card with the word casa on it is her partner. Comprende, Starburns? Okay. See you Friday. Find your partners. Have a great day. And what do we say at the end of every class? Hasta luego. Come on, hands, 90% of Spanish. Hasta luego. Excelente. Good.
Abed, do you want to trade cards?
No.
I'll give you 20 bucks.
No.
50 bucks.
No, I don't want your money. I want your shirt.
What?
I've had my eye on it since registration day.
All right, fine. Give me your card.
I don't think you understand. I want to wear it out of here.
Thanks.
Gracias.
What
are the odds?
Are you sure you didn't adjust the odds? I know Abed's been eyeing that shirt for 3 weeks. It's almost like you gave it to him so he would switch cards.
I gave Abed my shirt because I'm not selfish, which is something I guess you'll finally discover while we are working on this. Tomorrow night, dinner, drinks.
I think that's something that we should discuss with our partners. Oh, see, I did switch cards.
Can you believe this? What are the odds?
It's a nice shirt. Want to sell it?
Yes.
What's the moist towelette industry like?
Oh, believe me, it's nothing like the product. No, it's a hard, dry, large business. Destroyed all my marriages. Of course, it didn't help any that I can't have children. I'm not sterile. In fact, it's a rare condition called hypervirility. Apparently, my sperm shoot through the egg like bullets. Can you believe that?
I can't, but you can, so that's fine. So the assignment is to write a Spanish conversation using those five phrases.
Ooh, Hemingway's lemonade.
We don't need to make this a long evening.
What am I, a piece of garbage to you?
What? No.
Got you. Hey, come on. Let's have one drink before we work. Mm-mm-mm. To the empowerage of words.
To the irony of that sentence.
So what's up with you, Jeffrey? It seems like you got a burr up your ass or something.
Well, I guess that it's, I think it's Britta.
Forget Britta. All you have to know about her is her name. What is she, a water filter? I mean, she's ugly.
Why don't we start with me saying, donde la...
What the hell are you doing?
our assignment.
Oh, no, no, no. This is the first time people are going to see Winger and Hawthorne together. We're going to show them we're a force to be reckoned with. Come on, let's brainstorm some story ideas. Better yet, before we do that, let's ask ourselves, what is a story?
Oh, my God in heaven.
If you like that brownie, you're going to hate what's going on in Guatemala, I'll tell you that. Google it.
Praise the truth.
Okay, once it gets dark, I hand out the candles and we do what's called a speechless protest. We put tape over our mouths and gather hand in hand in a sea of outraged silence.
Starburns, no.
What's gotten into you? This is not how you do this.
Well, we know it's not how you do it because we're doing everything.
Yeah, but this is tacky and lame. I didn't mean that. I didn't mean that. I'm sorry. What I meant to say is that this cause is really personal to me.
Are you saying that we're not allowed to protest? Britta, you sound like Guatemala.
Sounds like somebody has the case of likes to use fringe politics to make themselves feel special, but doesn't actually ever want to do anything. Itis.
No, I do things. I went to... I don't do anything. What can I do? You can hang the Chicada Panegas Pinata. You guys realize he was beaten to death, right?
That's where we got the idea from.
Poignant.
All right. Okay, tell me what I've got so far.
What we have so far? Well, we have something incredibly long and very confusing and a little homophobic. And really, really specifically, surprisingly, and gratuitously critical of Israel. And it's called Two Conquistadors, should probably be Dos. I mean, it is a Spanish class. But which reminds me, the only thing not included in this epic are the five phrases required to get me a passing grade.
You're right. Needs more work.
What are you guys doing?
I have no idea.
Well, we're headed to the demonstration.
What, hippies?
Some cause Britta's into.
It's a silent protest, lots of candles. Gets the ladies in the mood for social change, if you know what I mean. Good chance to put some miles on this shirt.
You realize these conversations are due in the morning, don't you?
Oh, yeah. Right. What do you want to do?
Hola, me llamo Abed.
Hola, me llamo Troy.
¿Dónde está la biblioteca?
La biblioteca está en la ciudad.
Gracias.
Hacks. Okay, what are we going to do about the ending of Act 2?
I tell you what we're going to do. We're going to take this, and we're going to put it in a museum for crazy people. And then we're going to take this and memorize five phrases from it tomorrow morning before class. Good
wait
night.
Wait a minute. You're bailing on our first sausage fest? This is your definition of friendship?
No. This is my definition of you trying way too hard and me finding it harder and harder to stay polite. Now, this was a fine enough way to spend an evening devoid of hope, but the woman I kind of like is out there in the moonlight caring about something stupid. And this is my chance to show her that I care enough to act like I care about it too.
That's all you had to say, Jeff.
That was it? Oh, that would have been great if I had done that 2 hours ago.
Nice sign.
Thanks. I like what you've done with the place.
I think I was a little too harsh on you. I'm not perfect.
I am. I'd be happy to show you the ropes.
Awesome! Look at awesome Jeffrey Winger. Too awesome for old Pierce with your hip shirts and your gelled hair and your cool tape over your mouth. Why is everybody wearing tape over their mouth?
It's a protest, Pierce.
Oh, good. Because I know what I'd like to protest. How much you hurt me.
Conflicts like these will ultimately bring us together as an unlikely family.
You have horrible breath right now.
First, you constantly blow me off. Then you want me to do your homework. Okay. Then you tell me I'm trying too hard to be your friend, so you have to go. You have to come out here to 10 to care about.
I'm